Prophet Yaqub, he went through severe depression, grief, subhanAllah. Lost a son. I mean, he probably thought he died. So Allah mentions the Quran, even though he's a prophet, yet he also experienced grief. He is a prophet. He's a human being. That's a lesson for us. And then subhanAllah, when we come to the final messenger of Allah, Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, he is concerned for the ummah. There's a level we can't understand. He had so much empathy. He could not, and as the ayah says, do not grieve yourself to death over them. His concern was so much that he also felt grief. Strange is the affair of the believer, that when something good happens, he or she says Alhamdulillah. And when something bad happens, we say Alhamdulillah. That is an amazing way of looking at life. That we cannot lose in any way. Whatever happens, we say Alhamdulillah. When Allah wills good for someone, He afflicts him with trials and tests. We're always going to be tested. In the dawah, we get questions and I get DMs, right? And most of the DMs, I'll be honest, say, I'm going through a severe test. I'm going through a problem, brother. I'm going through this. And it's the tone is very worrisome. It's very end of the world. And the way I start my advice is, by the way, congratulations, bro. Congratulations, sister. They go, hold on. I've come to you with a stressful situation. I'm crying here. I'm sad. You're saying congratulations. I said, because you've been chosen by Allah. You've been chosen. Allah has put you through a test. This is the best days. You should be happy. You should be proud. So it's when you're not tested, you should be worried. everything's cushy. Work, job, family life. No stress. Alhamdulillah. You should be worried. Why? What's going on? Allah forgotten me. This is the way we look at it. Subhanallah. Alhamdulillah for Islam, right? Only in the remembrance of Allah do hearts find peace. It's a very powerful ayah. So that's something we need. Are we not all looking for peace at all times, brothers and sisters? Right? You call it happiness, but it's, ultimately it's peace. Peace of mind, peace of heart, comfort. We're looking for that peace, that inward peace, right? And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the creator of everything that exists, the creator of the heart, the creator of feelings and thoughts, emotions, He is saying, and He, you can't disagree with Allah. You think that by remembering wealth, or remembering cash, or your cars, or families, or fame, or power, that will give you peace. No. Remembering me, remembering Allah. So how do we get that? There's so many ways, right? One thing is dhikr, constant dhikr. And subhanAllah, with dhikr, there's different types of dhikr, remembrance of Allah. There's the morning and evening adhkar, as we say. Literally, 10 minutes in the morning and 10 minutes in the evening, 20 minutes of your whole day, right? You feel good because you're remembering Allah's name, you're mentioning Allah, and it stirs your body and your soul. And there's also tafakkur, which is thinking about deeply about things, deeply contemplating. The other one is salah. Look, we all have to pray salah 5 times a day, If I'm really honest, a lot of us see a salah as a burden. How many of us thought about, I'm going to get my salah out of the way. Let's get the salah out of the way. What we need to do, brothers and sisters, is we need to look forward to the salah. Salah is supposed to be connection with Allah, right? Isn't the salah the time when you think of all your dunya chores? It's true, isn't it? That's the time when you're supposed to be somewhere else. You're actually thinking about all the bills and I've got to pay my VAT. Oh, tax invoice is coming up. I've got to meet thingy for dinner. Oh. The reason that is because what we're saying, we don't understand what we're saying. When we're praising Allah and asking for guidance, the words in Arabic, we do not know. So let's make an effort of understanding the salah in a language we know. Salah is a time where you can converse and talk to Allah. You can pour your heart out. Look forward to the sujood. Look forward to your head on the floor. And after praising Allah, talk to Him. Talk to Allah. Complain to Allah. Talk to Him. Demand from Allah.